Canadian Peter Carruthers will be next. The four-time U.S. champions, let's meet them up close and personal.
They've been training in Wilmington, Delaware for several years now. Every trip home to Burlington, Massachusetts is a sentimental journey for Peter and Kitty Carruthers. For this brother and sister pair, Burlington's where it all began.
This street right here is probably the whole reason we started skating when we were kids. We used to come over here and sled right down this hill here. My parents were always afraid that we'd go right out in the street. So they built us a backyard rink to keep us off the street.
I didn't realize at the time how fortunate it was starting with a very small patch of ice, because this meant after they took perhaps three strokes, they had to turn, and there was no barrier or no fence at that time for them to lean on or to stop them. So they just had to stand up and skate and not hang on to anything. Kitty, she started ballet when she was 2.5 or 3 years old and loved it.
I think she was always interested in what the camera was doing. She was, you know, performing, and I guess we were her audience. Absolutely fearless. She wanted to do everything that Peter did, and she matched him. You know, she got on the horse and jumped. They just grew up and enjoyed the same things when they were younger, and they had the same brother and sister quarrels. I mean, they were no different.
But they were different, really. Unlike most children, they were dedicated. They took ice dancing, then changed to the pairs event. That led to leaving home in their mid-teens to go to the best coach they could find in Wilmington. Were they homesick?
We were very homesick for them. You know, it's difficult to part with your children because Kitty was only 15 then. You know, it's hard to let a 15-year-old go. But wonderful to have a 17-year-old brother.
Right now, we're just working with everything. We're trying to be faster. We're trying to get the lines from ballet and jazz class. We're working on our presentation. We're weak, you know, all over. We're just trying to get stronger in every area.
Figure skating is so beautiful that people tend not to realize how physical it is. For Peter and Kitty, it means exercise and dance classes all afternoon.
He's tough on himself and on me, and I try to be the same. We're both perfectionists.
That's probably our biggest problem. We work sometimes too hard.
That's much, much better. You maintain, actually your legs are even above horizontal there.
Later there's a break for dinner, but then back for 4 or 5 more hours of work.
I think you really don't compete against somebody, because then you lose the whole thing. Sure, you want to be the best, you want to win, but I think you're always really competing with yourself.
So get it right away, and then you develop that bridge right away. Okay, go ahead.
Alrighty.
The man they moved to Wilmington to study under is Rod Luddington, one of the best pairs coaches in the world, a real taskmaster.
Okay, now watch your position now, Kitty.
Skating is an endless quest for perfection, a sport where you're judged not by being the fastest, but by how close you can come to that perfect mark of 6 on every small move. So the search for perfection goes on. This is how it looks to Peter in the endless hours of work they put in preparing for these Olympics. And remember, they've been doing this for most of their waking hours as long as they can remember. That's how they got to be champions. And in the exciting, glamorous world of skating, what does one champion say to the other at the end of the day's work?
I'm ready for bed.
Yeah, no doubt. So I'll see you in the morning.
Yep, I'll call you in the morning.
Okay.
Kitty and Peter Carruthers, and there are more Americans, I think, than any other contingent in the stands. The USA chant begins. They'll quiet down now, though, as we get set for the routine of the Carruthers.
Their first move, a split twist. Here it is. infamous double loops? They both did them, but they didn't do them exactly in unison. Fair combination spin. First sit spins. Up, down. Repair, camel. Footwork. Side by side sit spins. Position on Kitty at that point. Good position.
Nice performance.
Nice performance for them. And obviously they felt it too. You can see the two of them very happy with each other.
Kitty and Frieda Carruthers with the door open. Soviet pair of Belova and Vasiliev with an excellent routine. The USA USA chant, which has become so familiar at the Olympics, whether they are in Lake Placid or Sarajevo, saluting them as they leave the ice.
Certainly no major mistakes in that performance. But one that I think should leave them relatively happy with their position at this point.
Kitty and Peter Carruthers, you would think they would be in no worse than second position after these marks come up, and that's our initial feeling anyway. Coming in, most people felt that they'd be in contention for a bronze medal. That would be pretty good, but with what's happened so far tonight, they have to be thinking about more than that. At least the opportunity is there. Now coming up for technical merit and a low of 5.4 from the British judge, all the way up to 5.8 from the American judge. What do you think of those marks, Dick?
Not good marks. Not good marks. I don't think they were particularly effective marks on the part of the judges. And I certainly don't think a 5.5 and a 5.4 and a 5.5 here from judges 1, 3, and 6 are right.
Well, there are the marks judge... now for artistic impression.
Well, what do you think?
I felt good. I don't know.
This is great.
You should
the crowd was
the
great.
The Americans here are fabulous.
I wish I could go give every American a kiss. They were so fantastic.
What do you think about the marks?
Oh, the heck with the marks. We just came over here to...
do that.